Hi friends, how are you? In this video clip, I am going to brief you on the spinning department, that is preparatory process department, that is drawing department. In my first video on my lectures, that is blurum line already I covered. Second department, carding I covered. In this video, I am going to brief you on drawing department. See, in blurum, just I'm highlighting the points. In blurum, the cotton, 3 to 4 varieties of cottons are mixed homogeneously and subjected to opening, baiting and cleaning, dust and dirt removal and reduction in the tuft or lumps of the fibers. Big lump is converted to small tuft is converted to small fringes. Okay. Hope it is disturbance is there, surrounding near railway station is there here. Okay, I'm shooting this videos in my top of my house. Okay, in blurum the incoming input is the raw cotton, output is lap formation or chute fitting. Please visit my channel, watch the videos. I release more than 135 videos are available, including short videos. In short videos, fabric analysis is done. Most of the fabric I started on fabric, giving the analysis of the fabric, count construction of different types of the fabrics. Please visit and watch it. Okay, and next department is carding department. The carding is a heart of the spinning mill, because 50% of the spinning is taken place in carding department. In carding department, the fringe or small tuft of the fibers are individualized each other, free from each other. Dust and dirt, whatever is remaining, is that is removed and paralyzed, and output of the carding machine is the web formation. That web formation is the form of the web, whatever the output is there, that is condensed in the condenser roller and coiled in proper packaging in the cylinder. Coiling is taken place in the carding cans. Those carding cans are fed to the drawing frame as a raw material. The raw material for the draw frame are the carding cans. Okay, now I will start draw frame. See, what is the process is there in the draw frame? So what is the intention, purpose of the draw frame in the spinning mill? This is the question. 50% of spinning taken place in carding department, because the tuft, big lumps tuft of cotton, okay, and entangled cotton, lumps of cotton, balls of cotton are freed and converted into a rope form. That rope form is called carding sliver. That carding sliver is cannot be fed to the simplex directly to make roving, because in to make the counts in the ring frame department, either that is the finer counts or coarser count, whether it is a combed vasari count or carded count, okay, whatever is there, based on that final production of the yarn, the draw frame is decided. And second thing is, the to give the property of cohesiveness, to give the property of twisting each other, holding each other, to give the diameter to the yarn, to give the strength to the yarn, to parallel the fibers each other so that the fibers hold together as a, because of their natural cohesiveness property in the cottons. Okay. And in carding sliver, even though in carding the fibers are individualized but not parallelized perfectly, through the axis of the, in geometry I'm talking in axis, axis to the fibers are not parallel axis to the sliver, hardened sliver. Only frayed fibers are converted into rope form. Some percentage are gets paralyzed, not all percentage. To make them still parallel, okay, draw frame is required. In draw frame, the raw material is all, there is a creel, there is a creel in the draw frame machine, back creel. In the back creel, left side of the creel, four carding can, or right side of the creel, four cans are there. Here, this 4+4 cans are used to fed in conventional draw frames. But in case of modernized RSB, draw frames are there. Auto level draw frames are there. They are usually three cans are used to fed. Whatever 3+3 or 4+4 together, all suppose I'm now I'll consider only conventional. Here left four carding cans, right four carding cans, 4+4, all 8 carding cans together taken to the zone. What zone? Drafting zone. Drafting zone. In the drafting zone, okay, all these 8 slivers are fed parallelly. Okay, fed parallelly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, fed parallelly and subjected to drafting. Fibers are drawn. Whatever the web, whatever the sheet of 8 sliver is coming, all 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, say 1, 2, 3, 4 slivers are there, all slivers are fed into the drafting zone. All drafting zones, in drafting zone, drafting of the fibers taken place. Drafting of the fibers taken place. And finally, there also the output of the drafting zone is, again web will form, the thin sheet of web will come out. That web is again like in carding machine, here also it is taken to the condensing roller and coiler to make package in the can, that is drawing cans. The input is 8 carding sliver, output is 1 drawing can. Where the process is taken place? 8 carding cans are converted into 1 drawing cans, okay, through drafting zone. Okay, now I will talk about the drafting zone. In drafting zone, in the system, the drafting zone is made, there are top rollers will be there, bottom rollers will be there. Top rollers are sit on the bottom rollers with the pressure, pneumatic pressure, hydraulic pressure, that is called pneumatic pressure. And these rollers, top rollers and bottom rollers, are made of ebonite, like rubbers. And also, the arrangement of drafting rollers, usually 3 top rollers, 3 bottom rollers, that is called 3 up, 3 down drafting zone. Sometimes the adjustment is like 4x4 drafting rollers, 4 up, 4 down. Sometimes 3x5, top 3 rollers will be there, bottom 5 rollers will be there. And also important here in the drafting zone is, whatever you consider, top rollers are not subjected to any mechanical rotations, any mechanical force to rotate. Only the top rollers are rotate only because of the pneumatic pressure on them, on the pressure on the top bottom rollers. Because of the bottom rollers, because of the in touch with the bottom rollers, they are also rotating. And whatever, and the speed, say I'm considering here example 3x3 rollers, I'm considering 3 up, 3 down rollers. Front roller, that is one pair, top and bottom. Middle roller, top and bottom, one pair. Third pair, back up roller, back bottom roller. So first pair, second pair, third pair, front rollers, middle rollers and back rollers. All carding cans rollers, eight slivers, carding slivers are fed first to the back rollers and it is moved and in touch with the when the eight slivers passed by the back rollers, when come in contact with the middle roller, then drafting, first drafting of the card slivers taken place. Why? What the mechanism? Because the speed of the middle roller, the speed of the bottom middle roller is more than the speed of the back roller. Because of the difference between the speed of next roller, middle roller and back roller, the drafting is drawing up the fibers taking place. Because of the drafting, fibers are get stretched, paralyzed. This is first drafting. Next, that stretcher drafted, first drafted fringe is again pass and come in contact with the first pair of the roller, front roller. There also still more stretching takes place because the front roller speed RPM, revolutions per minute RPM, is more than the middle roller RPM. Middle roller RPM is more than the back roller RPM. Because of the speed variations, the drafting, first drafting and second drafting takes place. Finally, output of the front roller, what is there? It is a web. It is a fringe of web, fringe will be there. The quantity, how much quantity? 8 carded slivers are fed, but the output is only, the quantity, back quantity is more, but the output quantity is how much quantity? It equals to the one carding sliver. The diameter of the output of the drafting zone is equal to the diameter of the one carding cans. But what the changes take place? What the formation? What the improvement? What the development takes place? All fibers, the outcome fibers are all are gets paralleled each other. Okay, that is called drafting. And second drafting, this one process takes place. And between the front roller and the condenser roller, that is a gap is there, no? That whatever web is coming and condensed to the front condenser roller is there, between that web is condensed and whatever the coiling is taking place, this little bit twisting is inserted to that outcome fibers. Okay, that is called drawing sliver. Whatever the drawing outcome sliver is there, fringe is there, and convert into coiler sliver, that is called draw frame sliver. In that draw frame sliver, 1 to 2 turns per inch twist is inserted, only to hold, only to give the strength to the draw frames, only to give the strength to the draw frames. Okay, now otherwise fibers are disturbed, entangled. So to keep them hold together, the twisting is given. Okay, and drafting is over, twisting is over. Next, winding that sliver, draw frame sliver is winding in the can, that is packing of the drawing slivers. This is the process of the draw frames, whether it is a conventional, whether it is an auto leveler or modernized, technically developed, whatever is there. Even present 21st century model is there. This is the only basic process will be there. Okay, now this is a point, this is a process. But I am planning to give still more videos in deep about the mechanical arrangement, mechanical part of the spinning preparatory and frame process and other things here, geometry calculations, spinning calculations and whatever so much of is there, I will come in the other videos. And one more, in this draw frame, I am giving very important point is, like carding, here also humidity play an important role. Humidity of the draw frame, humidity of the drawing frames, drawing frame departments is a very, very important. Control of the humidity, control of the moisture, in the drop frame is very, very important, like carding machines, because the in drafting zone, the rollers, front rollers, middle rollers, back rollers, they are rotating with different speeds, drafting zone with different speeds, and also it is because pressure between the ebonoid rollers, top and bottom rollers, ebonoid rollers are there, differential speeds are there, and also gearing box is working differently. So if humidity is, temperature is more, departmental temperature is more, if moist is less, what will happen? Jam, fiber jam will take place in the drafting zone, especially front rollers will jam, web will cut, break, drop frame will stop, and auto leveler, whatever the feeding is there, there also the feeding of carding sliver will stop, breakdowns will increase if temperature is not controlled, if moist is not controlled. In as per my experience, I worked as a supervisor in spinning mill. Okay, to clear that jam, drafting zone jam, okay, production loss will be there, quality will go, next simplex will stop, combing will stop, so much of thing is there. So humidity control is a must. Always the labor who is attending the particular drop frame, he has to concentrate back and front. Proper feeding is a must. Okay, now modern technology is there, auto levelers are there, auto stoppages are there, adoption of the software is there, microprocessors are there, automatic can changers are there, everything is there. But even though humidity is a must, humidity control is a must. Okay friends, now up to now I covered blow room line, carding and draw frame. Now I will come in the next video, what combing department. In combing department, whatever the why combing is required, sometimes what will happen, draw frames suppose carded, there are two types, I told you there are two types of yarns are spun in the spinning ring frame, one is carded count and second one is hosiery, that is combed count. For hosiery, knitted goods, combed cot yarns are used. For coarser, say normal fabrics, for coarser counts, so say for pant or whatever is there, the end users, that is carded count. For carded count, directly draw frame cans are fed to the simplex. Okay, now for hosiery count, for knitted goods, for finer count, say finer count means above 50s, even 40s count, 50s count, that is for cambric, for voile, or for 120s count, they are all required. Parallel, still more parallel fibers are required, high length fibers are required. Here the purpose of going to comber is to avoid, to remove the short fibers. Short fibers, see in comber, short fibers will be removed, only maintaining the same length fibers, staple length is maintained in the comber for hosiery products. That's why the third department, that is not required, it required only for special works. Suppose the mill is working for carded count, then combing department is not required. Okay friends, I'll come with the other video for combing. Okay, I'm very much thankful to my subscribers. I'm going to reach thousands, more than thousands. Okay, please watch and support, and please like it and share it. Okay, please click the icon bell for next notifications. Thank you very much.